The Republic of Indonesia in Southeast Asia comprises some 17,000 islands. Much of Indonesia lies within an area that has been termed the Coral Triangle, reaching to Malaysia in the west, the Philippines in the north, and Papua New Guinea and the Solomon Islands in the east. This region has been designated on account of its extraordinary marine biodiversity. A combination of warm water, tropical light, and enriching ocean currents has created ideal conditions for a myriad of aquatic creatures to thrive. More than 500 species of coral and more than 3,000 species of fish live here. The Coral Triangle has been called the global centre of marine biodiversity and is a focus for many conservation efforts. At the heart of the sprawling Indonesian archipelago and of the Coral Triangle lies Sulawesi, the 11th largest island in the world. Much of Sulawesi is fringed by hard coral reefs. For example, at Bunaken Island, off the North Sulawesi coast near Manado, pristine coral reefs teem with tropical fish. Down below, green turtles rest on ledges in the reef wall. Schools of pelagic fish patrol the deep blue water of the coast, and the occasional shark cruises by. Across the North Sulawesi Peninsula lies Lembeh Island, separated from the mainland by the Lembeh Strait, a waterway some 15 kilometers long and 1 to 2 kilometers wide. The undulating coast is lined on both sides by rainforest and plantations of coconut palms, which are farmed primarily for their oil. The strait is overlooked by Mount Klabat, a dramatic dormant volcano on the Sulawesi mainland. The busy town of Bitung lies at the southern end of the strait and is Sulawesi's main deep water port. The underwater landscape here is quite different. Much of the seabed consists of gently sloping plains of dark sand and silt, tiny fragments of volcanic lava that can appear barren at first. Visibility is more limited, and newcomers might be forgiven for wondering why they are here. But a closer look reveals a vast array of life, supported by the currents passing through the sheltered strait and nutrients from the mineral-rich substrate. Many of the animals are unusual and exotic species rarely seen elsewhere. The area is a popular breeding ground for many species, and the juveniles often stick around during their development. Over the years, a lot of refuse has been discarded into the strait from passing boats or from the shore. Everything from bottles to tires is encountered underwater. Although some of the trash is undoubtedly toxic, in many cases it has become integrated with the natural features and is an important part of the underwater ecosystem. On a seabed with relatively little natural shelter, everything that can be used as a habitat invariably is. Pioneering explorers first discovered Lembeh's charms in the 1990s. The term muck diving had been coined for similar dives in Papua New Guinea, and Lembeh soon became a mecca for this growing activity, and in particular for macro photographers and videographers. Several dive centres have since been established on both sides of the strait, and liveaboard vessels occasionally visit too. Despite the extra traffic, there is plenty to go around, and many stretches of the coastline have been recognised and christened as dive sites. Although coral reefs are sparse, the muck is punctuated by occasional oases of life, such as this colony of branching flowerpot coral on the slope at TK2. These Xenia soft corals also sit isolated at Nudie Retreat. The pulsating movement of the tentacles is not to catch plankton, as is commonly thought, because the polyp mouth and digestive tract are no longer functional. Rather, the motion enhances gas exchange and assists the uptake of dissolved nutrients from the water. Such sessile animals, those that are fixed in one place, succeed in spots where currents are plentiful. The exposed reefs at Critter Hunt in the middle of the strait are ideal for ascidians or sea squirts. This is a colony of stalked ascidians rooted to one of the reefs. Water is inhaled through the larger hole, the oral siphon. Organic particles are filtered out for food, and the water and waste products exit via the smaller atrial siphon. This nearby compound ascidian consists of many small individuals, each called a zooid, forming a single sheet-like colony with a shared circulation. Symbiotic relationships between marine creatures are crucial to many species' survival underwater. ¶¶